You can feel the skin of the
cotton.
No, the bunny.
Yeah, no. Look at the mink.
Look, you want to touch a possum?
No.
Look.
No.
Look, he's got soft fur. Muskrat?
No, see.
Damn, this thing is soft.
This is what people pay for.
So. Look, I'm getting a muskrat as a pet.
How about badger?
Badger.
Why not just go with a bobcat? Oh, somebody just wrong. Pulled his hair off.
Raccoon. Damn, look at all this. It was a hairy guy.
Mm-hmm.
Look, the otter saying hi.
Mm-hmm. This one's saying feed me.
Woof.
Did you know that wolves don't actually howl at the moon?
Man, it feels like,
rough.
What is this? Is this a bobcat?
Mm-hmm. Ew, that's rough.
Coyote.
I bet you his hair is soft.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Now this dude is rough.
So...
See, this is why they see it in the park. It's common in Iowa.
Yeah. That's probably what they're seeing there at the campsite.
Mm-hmm, the red one. And he's red, he don't even look red.
Soft.
Mm-hmm, he was stinky.
Who's this? Skunk?
Spotted skunk.
Got soft hair.
I thought he had.
There's a breeder here in Iowa.
A beaver. Ew, this is the stinky one.
This one feels like the wolf here.
Mm-hmm, it looks like matted rough. Elk.
Bison.
No, it's rough.
Look at this guy. Place is big. You can go around this little. Oh, look. Look at the butterflies.
That's it.
When do they,
It has it on the outside.
Can you see real good because of the glass?
Wow, look at that. Some of the fossils. Oh, this is what I study.
I don't know what they do there. Red gears. The puppet show. Hey, I'm hungry. Feed me.
Where's the other one? Let's see.
What you looking for? An owl?
No, the other one.
Oh. raccoon.
Okay. There you go.
There's Rosemary. She's gonna do a puppy chow. Supposed to have two of them.
He's gonna eat.
Get out of there.
It was tempting. Are these the golden eggs? Turtle eggs? This guy used to breed them.
This is a uniform they used to do control fires. I wish it didn't jump out of
there. I thought the same thing.
It's a hawk, right?
It looked like one.
Whoa.
Just got over here the information.
Thank you.
gonna turn the thing. The wheel. Slow.
I was scared to look at this hole. I might see something
I didn't want to see. So I'm gonna jump out of there. I think you're walking there.
I'll show you in a minute.
Oh, look, the big eyeball right there.
Someone that's over here scared the heck out of me. Look at yourself.
What do you say?
It's over here. I walked over here and did like this. And they looked at me and I ran the other way. Look.
Damn.
That's what scared me. I was like, oh, you can go in there.
It's gonna eat you.
It did scare me.
This is a...
It's a kid's maze.
Kid's maze. Inside the maze, you can do crawling area.
Look up for whatever that is.
Damn, right there. You see how big it is? Right there, not gonna eat you.
I'm scary looking.
Let me see your phone.
And then you take a picture with him. Hey, dude, what's up? And it goes like that to the body. And then it reflects, it might reflect out the mirror.
Oh, you see yourself there.
Say cheese. Say no, don't get me. What's the other one do? Nothing.
Just little.
You can sit down in there.
No.
That thing is scary.
These are the tunnels that the critter makes.
The what?
This critter here, the badger, whatever yeah. That thing is.
Oh my god, that's a huge badger. Never want to meet one like that.
No. Gophers.
Mm-hmm. What's this? Push it. Press button and take x-ray. Stand in front of it. You want me to do it? Come back here.
They're the bison. They're way out there. See how close I can zoom in. A lot of sun glare on this time.
Previous ones.
Can you see the pictures? Good.
Yes. There we go. Push it in. Oops, nice head. Wow, we're the only ones. Cool.
We can get close with our Conroe Kingwood. From Houston, so, oops, sorry.
This map is to show where you're visiting from. Ooh, we're gonna see a movie.
Is it close, far?
Right here so we can see the whole picture. Come here.
The town square. A place for play or for relaxing on the grass. The rich lawn here is fed and tamed, a peaceful reminder that we are a part of the earth. Yet once, there was wildness here. Once the American prairie was here, as wild as any grasslands in the world. As wild as the African savanna. Half a world away, vast herds still thunder across the plains. We have only memories of the multitudes that roamed our land. Two 200 years ago, this land was tall grass prairie. Big blue stem, little blue stem, slough grass, ripcut, Indian grass, needle grass. Where now is corn, there once was prairie. Where now are cities and towns, there was prairie. Where now are counties and whole states, there was prairie. Where now the land is tamed, there was wildness. The wildness here came in many forms, each form fitting the prairie in a special way. Supported an abundance of wildlife. Those that took to the skies needed keen vision and the ability to battle the prairie winds in order to thrive. The American prairie was unique in the world. With few trees, homes here were confined to the earth. Protection from weather and from predators was found under the cover of the grasses themselves, or deep within the soil. The animals here were prairie animals, superbly adapted to living in this land. Was a land of extremes. Winter brought bitter cold and smothering snows. Those that could burrow deep and hibernate or take wing far to the south escaped the cruel winters. Those that remained endured. Spring brought renewal. The prairie was always restless. Summer brought heat, drying winds, and violent storms. Provider. Buffalo and elk hides were transformed to objects of daily use. Bird feathers were arrayed, displayed as ornamentation. Flowers and bones, herbs and seeds, wood, and the soil itself, all were used, changed by skilled hands and creative minds. To the prairie, These hands and minds brought a tool to help shape and control the wildness. Fire. But fire had its own wildness. There was nothing to stop a hungry fire. Prairie winds urged it to devour the dry grasses along a front miles long. To survive this trial by fire and to emerge strong. Each species, both plant and animal, adapted and changed, becoming part of this intricate community, and the prairie flourished. And because the prairie flourished, the buffalo thrived. More than 40 million of these magnificent animals roam this continent, vast herds consuming the grass and lifting plumes of dust as they ran wild, wild as the wind. Surveyors came. With them came ownership, ambitions, innovations, and plans. Settlers came for the riches hidden beneath the sod. Rich black loam formed from the grinding of glaciers and centuries of life and death of plant and animal. The richest soil in the world. Soil to dream about, soil to start a new life, soil that called the settlers west. The first homesteaders found the prairie unforgiving. The wooden plows were drawn by mules or oxen. The sod was heavy, the roots tough. A long day saw but a single acre turn. A single American innovation changed this world. The steel plow. It sliced and folded over the sod, and the prairie's riches were unlocked. The Midwest rapidly became America's provider and earned the name the breadbasket. The land became owned, used, populated. And the prairies. The prairies were divided, drained, smoothed, tamed. Within a single lifetime, most of the prairies were gone. Little blue stem became wheat. Big blue stem became corn. Where there was prairie, now there is us. And the wildness left. The buffalo left. The elk, the prairie chicken left. What remains of the prairie now lies in forgotten corners. Overgrown with trees, faint memories of a wildness long past. past has a future. The land here has been cleared, made ready, and the prairie is returning. The technology that broke the prairie is bringing it back. Thousand-acre National Wildlife Refuge. Enough for a community, a natural community. Bringing back part of our unique heritage, bringing back a portion of the prairie, is an ambitious undertaking. It will take a major effort and much ingenuity, but it can be done. And it must be done. For the prairie will once again provide game for hunters. Beauty for those who seek it. It will bring fascination, involvement, and education for young minds. It will be an outdoor playground, laboratory, and inspiration for us all. Already there are heartbeats here. Already things are happening. The wildness, long displaced, is finding its way home. Nothing quite like this has ever been done before. The process of bringing back wildness that has lain dormant in our land is a challenge and a fulfillment. This process is exciting. It will take time to restore what has been gone for over a century. But be patient, for it will come back, enough to remind us that once wildness here.
Thank you.
morning you can't see them, the weeds are so high. Where'd they go? He's all by himself. Let's go see if we find the other one. Well, this is as close as we getting. They don't want to come out. We found this one near the old fence. All by you lonesome. Well, till next time. Like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.